Good morning, my dear friends. Last class we have been completed the last exercise of the chapter differential equations. So today I am going to discuss the miscellaneous solved examples. And here he has given that totally 5 examples. And in that 5 questions, the question number 25 and question number 28. This year these two questions are not considered for your examination. Why? Because these two questions are solved from the concepts which are deleted from your syllabus. So in this class I just discussed the question number 24, 26 and 27. And the question number 24 is verify the function y is a solution of this given differential equation or not. Either the question na exercise 9.12, then you have 10 to 12 questions made. I hope all of you are able to verify the function y is a solution of this given differential equation or not. A one okay, just find the value of dy by dx and then find the value of d square y by dx square. Substitute the values of y, dy by dx, and d square y by dx square in the LHS of the given differential equation. If it is equal to 0, then we conclude that the given function y is a solution of the differential equation. If it is not equal to 0, then we conclude that the given function is not a solution of this given differential equation. So I just discussed the question number 26 and 27, which are most important for your examination purposes. And the question number 26 is, find the particular solution of the differential equation, log of dy by dx is equal to 3x plus 4y. Satisfying the conditions, y is equal to 0 when x is equal to 0. So to find the particular solution of this differential equation, first we need to find out the value of dy by dx. So for that, shift this log towards the right hand side. It will be converted in the form of exponential function. Hence, we get the value of dy by dx is equal to e power 3x plus 4y. Now, the value of dy by dx is equal to, so e power 3x plus 4y can be written as e power 3x into e power 4y. Now shift this e power 4y towards the left hand side and dx towards the right hand side. We get dy divided by e power 4y, which is equal to e power 3x into dx. After separating the variables, integrate on both sides. So integration of dy divided by e power 4y can be written as integration of e power minus 4y into dy is equal to integration of e power 3x into dx. So integration of e power minus 4y dy is e power minus 4y divided by minus 4 is equal to integration of e power 3x is e power 3x divided by 3 plus integral constant c. Now shift this minus e power minus 4y divided by 4 towards the right hand side. We get e power 3x divided by 3 plus e power minus 4y divided by 4 plus c is equal to 0. So here is the one. So LCM of 1, 3 and 4 is 12. So here multiplied by 4, here multiplied by 3, here multiplied by 12. So 4 into e power 3x plus 3 into e power minus 4y plus 12 into c, 12c divided by LCM is 12, which is equal to 0. Now shift this 12 towards the right hand side. 12 into 0 becomes 0. So we get 4 into e power 3x plus 3 into e power minus 4y plus 12 into c general solution of the given differential equation. Why? Because the arbitrary constant C is used. To find the value of C, he has given that the conditions y is equal to 0 and x is equal to 0. So now what? Y is equal to 0 when x is equal to 0. So when y is equal to 0 and when x is equal to 0, so 4 into e power 3 into 0, 4 into e power 0, 4 into e power 0, plus 3 into e power minus 4 into 0, e power 0, so 3 into e power 0, plus 1c is equal to 0, plus 1c is equal to 0. Now, the value of e power 0 is equal to 1, so 4 into 1, 4, plus 3 into 1, 3. So 4 plus 3 is equal to 7, plus 1 into 3 is equal to 0. So therefore the value of 1 into 3 is, shift this 7 towards the right hand side, minus 7. Hence the value of C is equal to minus 7 divided by 1. Substitute the value of C in the equation number 1, we get the required particular solution of the given differential equation. So equation 1 implies 4 into e power 3x plus 3 into e power minus 4y plus 12 into c. The value of c is minus 7 divided by 12, which is equal to 0. Now 12 by 12 get cancelled. So 4 into e power 3x plus 3 into e power minus 4y plus into minus minus 7 is equal to 0. This is the required particular solution of the given differential equation. I hope all of you understood. If possible, take a look. So now the miscellaneous example number 27. And the question is, solve the differential equation x into dy minus y into dx into y into sin y by x is equal to y into dx plus x into dy into x cos y by x. To solve this differential equation, first we need to find out the value of dy by dx. For that, x into y into sin y by x into dy is equal to what? Xy into sin y by x into dy minus y into y, y square into sin y by x into dx is equal to, so y into x cos y, y by x into dx, xy cos of y by x into dx plus x into x, x square cos of y by x into dy. Now the term which consists of the variable dy, this term and this term, so in both of these two terms we just take dy as a term. Before that, shift this the term towards the left hand side, and the plus x square cos y by x becomes minus x square cos y by x into dy. So common in the equation dy. The remaining term in the first term is xy into sin of y by x. On the inside one there is a minus. So minus x square cos y by x into, in between these two terms, the common term is dy. Is equal to, next in the term minus y square sin y by x dx and xy cos y by x dx, we will take dx as a common. Before that, we just shift this minus y square sin y by x dx towards the right hand side. Then the minus term becomes converted in the form positive. Therefore, xy this term, if you take dx as a common, the remaining term is xy into cos of y by x plus y square sin 90 x. In between these two terms, the common term is dx. Now, to find the value of dy by dx, shift this dx towards the left hand side. In total, this term, except the term dy, shift towards the right hand side. We get the value of dy by dx. Therefore, dy by dx is equal to xy cos of y by x plus y square into sin of y by x divided by xy into sin y by x minus x square into plus y by x. So you just observe here, this differential equation consists of terms of the form y by x. It means this is one of the homogeneous differential equation. To solve the homogeneous differential equation of the form dy by dx, we just substitute the value of y is equal to vx. We put one of the value, put the value of y is equal to vx. Since y is a function of x, so differentiate with respect to x. Differentiation of y with respect to x is dy by dx is equal to first function v as it is. Differentiation of x with respect to x is 1 plus second function x as it is. Differentiation of v with respect to x is dv divided by dx. And what is the next step? You just substitute the value of dy by dx and y in the given differential equation. So, that is the equation of it. The value of dy by dx is v plus x into dv by dx. V plus x into dv divided by dx is equal to x into y. The value of y is vx. Vx plus cos of y by x. The value of y is vx. It means the value of y by x should be equal to v. Therefore, cos of v plus y square means v square into x square. V square x square into sine divided by x into vx. The value of y is vx into sine v. Minus x square into cos v. When we are solving the homogeneous differential equation, we just convert the differential equation with the variables dv and dx. For that, the function which is present on RHS should be vanished from the function x. For that, we just take x square as a common. Taking x square as a common from both numerator and denominator. So, v plus x into dv by dx is equal to x into x is x square. So, x square. The remaining term is v into cos v plus v square into sine divided by x square. The remaining term is v into sine minus x square is common. Remaining term is cos. Now x square and x square get cancelled. The remaining term is v plus x into dv by dx is equal to v cos v plus v square sin v divided by v sin v minus cos v. Next step, shift this v towards the right hand side. Plus v becomes what? Minus v. So x into dv by dx is equal to v cos v plus v square sin v divided by v sin v minus cos v plus v becomes minus. So again you will have one. Now the LCM of 1 and v sin v minus cos v is v sin v minus cos v. Here multiply by 1. Here multiply by v sin v minus cos v. Therefore, x into dv by dx is equal to v cos v plus v square sin v. Now, v sin v into minus v plus into minus minus v into v, v square into sin v. Then minus cos v into minus v, minus into minus plus v into cos v is v cos v divided by v sin v minus cos v, v sin v minus cos v. Next, plus v square sin v, minus v square sin v get cancelled. Now v cos v plus v cos v is 2v into v cos v. Therefore, x into dv by dx is equal to 2v cos v divided by v sin v minus cos v. Now we get the differential equation with the variables dv and dx. Next thing is we just separate the variables dv and dx. For that, shift this v cos v divided by v sin v minus cos v towards the left hand side, x by dx towards the right hand side. So space factor is equal to minus 32. So v cos v divided by v sin v minus cos v towards the left hand side. It becomes what? V sin v minus cos v. V sin v minus cos v divided by v cos v into dv is equal to 2 into, shift this x by dx towards the right hand side, it becomes what? Dx divided by x. Now after separating the variables, integrating on both sides, now integration of v sin v minus cos v divided by v cos v. Now it comes to separate the integrals. Integration of v sin v divided by v cos v dv minus integration of cos v divided by v cos v dv. Integration of v sin v divided by v cos v dv minus integration of cos v divided by v cos v dv is equal to 2 into integration of dx divided by x. Now here v and v get cancelled. Integration of sin v divided by cos v is integration of tan v dv minus integration of cos v get cancelled. Integration of 1 by v dv is equal to 2 into integration of dx divided by x. So integration of tan v dv is log of secant v minus integration of 1 by v dv is log v is equal to 2 into integration of dx by x is log x plus integral constant c r plus log m minus log m is equal to log m by m. So log of secant v divided by v is equal to n log m. N log m is log m power n. So 2 log m becomes log of x square plus log c. No. Log m plus log n is equal to log m n. So that is log of secant v divided by v is equal to log of x square into c. Now, cancelling log on both sides, we get second b divided by b is equals to x square into c. So therefore the value of second b is equals to b into x square, sorry, x square into c. So b into x square c. Now first now y is equals to bx of the substitute point. Now from this equation the value of b is equals to y by x. Substitute the value of b, x substitute point in y is equals to bx. Equation in the b get the value of b is equals to what? Y by x. Therefore, second term of b means second term of y by x is equals to b into x square c. The value of b is y by x into x square c. Now, 1x and 1x get cancelled. The remaining thing is second term y by x, which is equals to 1x is remaining here, x into y into c. And this is the required general solution of the given differential equation. I hope all of you understood. And this is all about the chapter differential equations. If possible, take a look.